Little Holy Spirit breathing to start our morning off. Good morning and welcome to Prayer and Devotion on this Sunday, August 2nd. It is good to be with all of you today. Good morning, Vinette, and good morning, Daniel and Esther. Good morning, Renetta and Siege and Andrea and Priscilla. Excuse me. Holding each one of you in prayer this morning. It's good to be with all of you. So I mentioned this yesterday too, and I just want to kind of mention it for the next couple of days. I'm going to be away. Although I am officially on vacation tomorrow, I will do prayer and devotion Monday and Tuesday. But we will not have Saturday and Sunday next week. So just letting you know, there will be no prayer and devotion on Saturday and Sunday. But today there is. So it is good to be here with all of you today. Welcome if this is your first time to prayer and devotion. I'm always amazed. I talk to people and they'll say, oh yeah, come on prayer and devotion. Not at 6:30, but at other times. It is good to have all of you here today, whether you're here at 6:30 or you're here at 6:30 p.m. That's fine too. I'm glad that you've joined us. My name is Cindy Stauffer. I am blessed and honored to be the pastor at the United Methodist Church at New Brunswick. And so, welcome today. So our devotion, oh my goodness. Did I really come in here without my scripture, without my Bible? This is the... Sorry about that. It's because we were preparing for worship yesterday. My Bible was in the other room. So today we're looking at Isaiah. So if you want to turn in your Bibles, Isaiah is a major prophet. So the prophets come at the end of the Old Testament, or what we call the Hebrew Bible. And today we're looking at Isaiah 58. Verses 13 through 14. Isaiah 58, 13 through 14. And we're looking at Sabbath today. If you refrain from trampling of the Sabbath, if you refrain, my eyes are getting mad. If you refrain from trampling the Sabbath, from pursuing your own interests on my holy day, if you call the Sabbath a delight and the holy day of the Lord honorable, if you honor it, not going your own ways or serving your own interests or pursuing your own affairs, then you shall take delight in the Lord. And I will make you ride upon the heights of the earth. I will feed you with the heritage of your ancestor Jacob, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken. I'm going to read it one more time. This is a good one, especially since today's Sabbath. If you refrain from trampling the Sabbath, from pursuing your own interests on my holy day, if you call the Sabbath a delight and the holy day of the Lord honorable, if you honor it, not going your own ways or serving your own interests or pursuing your own affairs, then you shall take delight in the Lord, and I will make you ride upon the heights of the earth. I will feed you with the heritage of your ancestor Jacob, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken. And our devotion is entitled Space to Exhale. Rest. That sounds so good, but it's really hard for me. Even when my physical body is at rest, my mind rarely is. I feel like I'm always juggling balls in my brain. My family's needs, home demands, work projects, the to-do lists never stop. Yet the Bible makes it very clear that we are to honor the Sabbath day and pursue rest. Literally, we are to hit the pause button on life once a week and guard our need to rest. Guard it fiercely, guard it intentionally, guard it even if our schedules beg us to do otherwise. But why? There are honest personal reasons we need to observe the Sabbath that will be unique for each person. There are private conversations we need to have with God. We all need to pause, to sit with God, and ask God to reveal some things to us. In our passage from Isaiah 58, 13 through 14, we hear these words: if your feet keep breaking the Sabbath and from doing as you please on my holy day, if you call the Sabbath a delight and the Lord's day, holy day, honorable, if you honor it by not going your own way and not doing as you please or speaking idle words, then you will find joy in the Lord. When I consider these words, something occurs to me. It's not just a day for me to give to God, it's a day established for me. God wants to give me something if only I will slow down enough to receive it. The Sabbath isn't merely a time to be observed, it's a time to be preserved. It's a time to discover our joy in the Lord. I need this. I want to be a preserver of this day, one who is determined to protect this day of personal preservation and rediscover the delight of God. The observer remembers to rest, but the preserver rests to remember. To remember that it's all about God. The observer remembers to rest and pause on the Sabbath day in order to follow a rule. The preserver does more than follow a rule. She follows God's desire and embraces God's purpose in the rest. He spends one day a week letting the wind of God's rest blow through him, cleaning out all she's been taking in during the week, and purifying soul exhale. It's all about pausing and connecting with God without the distracting chaos of our everyday routines. For one day a week, we step out of the fray and let God direct our day according to God's rhythm, not ours. God's rhythm preserves a space in us to hear God's voice, reveals the places that we're off track, and prevents us from being filled with unnecessary clutter. Quiet rest allows us to see the places where we're going our own way, the areas where we're more self-pleasing than God-pleasing, the idle words that need to be reined in. During the downtime, we can deal with the mental clutter and focus on the ways of God. The Sabbath makes this possible. Taking one day for rest gives my soul the freedom it so desperately needs, freedom to breathe, space to breathe, inhaling and exhaling in a gentle rhythm set by God. Lord, dear Lord, space to breathe. This is what I need today. Good morning, Minda and Betty. It is good to have you here today. Ah, yes, today is Sabbath. And I know each one of us may have a different Sabbath. It is not always Sunday. Honestly, my Sabbath is Friday. Although I do try to take more intentional time on Sunday to be present with God. I liked the idea that we are not only to be observers, but to be preservers, to be literally let our lives be preserved by this day, by this time with God. And so I think Sabbath is a really hard thing for, well, for me it is. but I think it is hard for all of us, especially in the society which we live in that really does not, even when we do have time off, we use that time for getting our laundry done or we've got a whole list of the things that we need to do when we're not at work, and so seldom do we really get that time to pause and be present with God, to really listen and be still. I'm not sure if I shared this with you, about my friend recently was saying that Sabbath rest, like boredom, that's what he said. Boredom means it's a Richard Rohr. When you are bored, it means that you are very close to God, like because it is that you are so still that God can't help but be right there, right? Whatever's next. If you're not keeping yourself busy, like we're used to just being busy, 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 busy. And even if we're not busy, we engage ourselves with like television or video games or surfing the web or whatever it is that you do. When you're not busy, we make ourselves busy all the time. So when we are actually bored, often we are still, which means that we are that much closer to God. He was telling me that his kids, when they would come to him and say, "Dad, I'm bored," he would pause and go, "That means God is really close." And they would laugh, "Dad, you're so embarrassing." But like, we don't do that. Like, how often do we do nothing? Like, how often are we really still? Without agendas, without plans, without books that we need to read, but just present and still with God. It just doesn't happen. But I do think it's really important for us. And this is what Sabbath is. Sabbath is not a day for us to get other things done. Sabbath is a time to be present with God, to really listen for what God might need to say to you today that you have not been able to hear in the busyness, to slow down and be present with the one who is most present with you. So I encourage you today on this Sabbath day. Maybe you're very good at this, so maybe I need to learn from you. Find time today to be still, to even be bored, to put away the to-do list, and to be present with God. Because God has things that we need to hear. So let's give it a try. Let's pray. Spirit of the living God, fall afresh on us this morning. Lord, we know that you are as close to us as our very breath. But we also know that too often we are blind, we are deaf, we are unwilling to be open to your presence because we are too busy for you, too busy for our neighbor, too busy even for the ones that love us the most. And so you call us to this Sabbath, not as a time to observe, but as a time for you to preserve our very souls. Open us this day to your presence. Help us to be still in the chaos, to sit and be present in the busyness of the world around us. Slow us down that we might hear you more profoundly this day. We lift all of this up to you, Lord. I lift up all of the people that are on the call this morning, all of the people that will hear this later as we go about our day. Lord, I lift up all of those that will come and worship with us today. Lord, I lift up all those in our communities, especially those in the city of New Brunswick. Help us, Lord, to know you more fully, to live in your word, to walk in your way. We lift all of this up to you, Lord Jesus, as together we pray the prayer that you taught your disciples, our Father, who art in heaven. Hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who have trespassed against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. It is good to be with you. Oh, good to hear, Rick. Rick got his glasses. Praise the Lord. Yesterday, if you watch worship today, you'll see I had to wear my glasses several times because I can't see as well as I once did. I noticed that as I tried to read the Bible today. Well, I want to encourage you to join us for worship today at 11. It will be a wonderful service. Next Sunday, Hillary will be preaching. That will be terrific. And the Sunday after, Reverend Sangwon Do, our district superintendent, will be preaching. So, but I encourage you to be with us at 11 and invite. This is such a easy time to share the good news. Just invite someone, send them an invite, or tell them what link to find us, or on what Facebook page. But I look forward to being with all of you in worship today at 11. Remember, my friends, that God loves you, and so do I. I'll see you at 11. Bye, friends.